Welcome to ZW3D Basic Operation Introduction. My name is Ben. This is the first lesson of a series of 3D design tutorial videos. In this video, you will learn ZW3D interface, file types, system settings, mouth operation, common hotkeys, how to customize interface and hotkeys. Let's get started. First, interface. This picture shows ZW3D 2013 version's interface. On top is Quick Access Toolbar, Title Bar, providing several different ribbon tools. Document Aware Toolbar, you will use it a lot. On the left is the Manager. In the middle is Work Area. On the bottom is the Prompt Line and Inputs Window. Second, file types. ZW3D provides the special file type called Mounted Object File. This file can hold many parts, assembly, drawing sheets, and CAM plans as you desire. System setting. On the configuration table, you can define the background, file folder, template settings, and other parameters as you want. In every ZW3D 2013 version, or Windows 7 operation system, the first step is to create a new file. ZW3D's file type, like I mentioned above, is a mounted object file. In this file, we can directly add a new object, such as creating a solid part. Now let's do an example. First, we name the part. Then, we quickly create a block and try to use the fillet feature. Pick these edges, change view to get the hidden edges. Okay, now we get it. We put a cylinder over the block. Continue to use the fillet feature. On the right menu, we can also pick other commands like chamfer. At the modeling interface, we can easily go to the 2D sheets, select templates. Now we can adjust these scales to create a standard view. Exit the 2D sheets and back to the previous interface. ZW3D file contains the solid parts and 2D drawings integrated in one file. Okay, let's see the configuration. On the configuration table, designers can set different parameters according to their habits. The part table, 2D, colors, and background. You can take different items to change the background. On the file table, we can define the default template and set the working file folder for directly saving and opening files. On my PC, I define ZW3D chaining in F drive as my working file folder. Okay, let's talk about the mouse operation. LMB, which stands for left mouse button, is for picking or unpicking objects. MMB, which stands for middle mouse button, it is used for confirming inputs or repeating the last operations. Also, we can zoom in, zoom out, or pan the objects with this button. For the right mouse button, we can rotate the object and important points. It is also very fast to get the right menu to do some available features. Here are some common hotkeys in ZW3D, such as Ctrl and A to zoom all, Ctrl and 1 to set a rotated origin, Ctrl and arrow to fast change different wheels. Let's see a detailed case. Open a new file. Choose Fillet feature. Pick the edges. You can press Shift and left mouse button to select the tangents and edges, then pick. Here, users can also define the face attributes. then click OK. Use the right mouse button to rotate the object. Now click the middle mouse button to repeat the last operation to do fileting again. Select, shift and click the left mouse button. Continue. Okay, on the right menu, we can also unpick the last. Now for others, we can unpick them using Ctrl and left mouse button. On the right menu, we can also do some other operations. It is very convenient to find out the features. From this view, we can switch to the top view with Ctrl and up. Press Ctrl and down to the front view. Pick the geometry, hold Ctrl and home to auto align view. Press Ctrl and A to zoom all, Ctrl and 1 to set a new rotated origin. See, it is very easy and simple to do these operations. Use the middle mouse button to zoom in this geometry, and you can pan it from left to right or anywhere you want. Move your mouse to the Document Aware toolbar. You can change different views, like remove hidden lines or display edges in shaded mode. Different users have different requirements and habits, so how to customize the interface in hotkeys? Let's see. Choose Customize. Now we are in the Transfer table to change settings of shape feature of basic shape section. Under the ribbon menu, the basic shape has a panel and menu like this. On the left, we can select the needed feature and drag it to the panel. Then continue to add the shell feature, also pull it onto the panel, add the pattern to menu as well as the mirror feature. Okay, so let's go back to the menu, apply them. You will find that the interface is changed. Its menu now includes pattern and mirror. Okay, let's continue to see the hotkeys. On the hotkey table, first, choose ribbon in the category. Search for extrude. Then set the hotkey as Shift and E. Search for Fillet. You can define the hotkey as Shift and F. Apply it. Okay, now let's check how it works. Press Shift and E to activate the extrude feature. Select this curve list to add extrude to the geometry. Define the jaw angle, then finish. Press Shift and F to activate the fillet feature. So you can see the hotkeys makes operations in ZW3D much more convenient than before.